Blackpool TV are at School Road this afternoon for the FA Cup clash between Squires Gate and Atherton Collieries. Gate booked their place in today's preliminary round with a 1-0 win against Colne and will be strong favourites against their First Division opponents this afternoon. Gate will look to put their league form to one side, having suffered defeats to Winsford United and Padiham. Gate currently lie in 20th position in the league and will hope a win today can kick-start their season. Atherton Collieries beat Earlham 4-0 to book a place in today's game. Manager Steve Pilling will hope his team can repeat more of the same again today. He's without two first-team players, but strike partners Hayne and Fielding both start. Squires Gate's Ben Fishwick is out of action for today's game, but we caught up with him prior to kick-off.
Ben, you must be disappointed to be missing out on today's game.
Yeah, it's been quite tough, really. I got a little injury at the start of the season, first game, and I rushed myself back, really, so it's not been good.
I mean, you got the winning goal against Colne so that we could be here today.
Yeah, I was looking forward to playing in the next round, actually, so there's a bit more money going into it, so I'm disappointed to be missing out, yeah.
How long do you think it'll be before you're back?
Well, I'm going to go and see the doctor, hopefully get a scan on it. It could be a couple of months, I think, maybe. So it's got to take me time, really. I've rushed myself back before and obviously scored in that game, but it's just gone again on me, so not good enough. I'll have to get it right.
We all wish Ben a speedy recovery and look forward to seeing him in action again soon. Back to this afternoon's game, Alex McKendrick gets a start today, as does Zach Thomas and Andy Harvey. Gaz Lewis has to settle for a place on the bench alongside Nigel Taylor, who makes a welcome return to the side after a lengthy injury. So with a place in the next round of the FA Cup at stake then, it's time to get down to the action. It was Gate who started the game the brightest on a rain-soaked afternoon. Andy Harvey finding Scott Harries on the left before laying it off to the left-back Thomas. His cross bringing an early save from Lee Novak, Andy Harvey followed up the rebound, but Andy Walker making a goal line clearance to deny him. A quick corner was almost sliced into the miners' goal, but for a fantastic save from Novak. Captain Tom Benfield came close on 11 minutes, his header going just wide of the goal. Gate midfielder Harries went on a terrific run in the 20th minute, a neat back heel from Mayers setting him on his way. As he drove down the pitch, the miners backed off, leaving Harries space to shoot, but once again Novak stood firm. Atherton's first chance of the game came on the half hour, the free kick going straight into the wall, Alex McKendrick taking the hit. Gate got their own free kick minutes later. Lewis Mayers with this effort. The miners' goal hanging on by a thread. Next to try and break the deadlock was Zach Thomas. After a neat 1-2 with Harries, Thomas shot straight at Novak. Gate's final effort of this one-sided half came when Rico Richards sent in a great cross. Andy Walker heading it to safety. Into the second half, and it was Atherton who had the first chance. Paul Hines finding space on the right, but his effort going just wide. But Squires Gate made the breakthrough minutes later. Harries winning the home side a corner. From the corner, Tom Bunfield rose the highest to head goalwards. Keeper Novak making an instinctive save, but Andy Harvey was there to nod it home. Another terrific save from the keeper, but Harvey on hand to make it Squires Gate 1, Atherton Collieries 0. Atherton had the next chance in the game. Jonathan Bridges' effort taking a big deflection, which just about looped Timey's goal. The miners' next chance came when a wayward throw out from Tiny went straight to Bridge. But his effort just skimming the post. A great pass from Thomas found Harvey in space. His shot going wide of the post though. Thomas was involved again on 75 minutes, rising well to meet a Richards cross, but his effort just going wide of the goal. Keeper Novak doing just enough to deny him. Squires Gate would then reduce to 10 men on 80 minutes when Tom Benfield brought Sam Parkinson down for his second yellow card of the afternoon. With Gate looking to see the last few seconds of the game out, the referee blew the whistle for full time to send Squires Gate into the next round of the FA Cup against either Runcorn Linnets or Mosley. Atherton put up a spirited fight in the second half, but Andy Harvey's 54th minute goal proved to be the winning goal of the game. We caught up with the two managers after the game, but first up is goal scorer Andy Harvey. That just leaves me to say thanks for watching. Join us again soon for more football action. And from all of us here at Blackpool TV, we will see you next time.
Andy, you got the winning goal today?
Yeah, right spot, right time, really. Wasn't anything special, just a corner whipped in. I think it was Benham that got a head on it. Just luckily bounced up and just nodded it in.
So. Was it already going in? Or?
No, keeper saved it, just bounced up in air. So, just like I said, just right spot, right time, just nodded it in.
Steve, were you pleased with your team's performance today?
Yes and no, yes. We knew it would be hard first 45 minutes because it's a 10-point, obviously the Premier Division's quicker than the First Division. And I said if we can live till half-time and hold it, I thought we could probably move on in the second half and take it on. But yeah, we kept the clean sheet, which was good because we've been struggling with that just lately. Rode our luck a little bit. Good last-ditch defending, which we've been talking about, you know, throwing bodies on the line and stuff. Did a lot of that. And I thought maybe Squires probably shaded the first half. There wasn't a lot in it because we had chances as well. But I thought the Premiership quality sort of, you know, was, you could see there was a bit of difference between the two teams. But I thought in the second half there was, it could have been anyone's game, to be honest. I'm on the whole, I'm probably pleased but disappointed, I'd say.
Russ, congratulations.
Yeah, thanks very much. It was a tough game that today, and the lads have put in a good second half. They're a good workmanlike performance. Unfortunately, one or two things didn't go our way in the first half, and I think the game should have been put to bed. Just the crossbar from Lewis, Andy Harvey's had a half-decent chance. Scotty's run through one. You know, we should have really been 2-0 up before the break and coast in second half. But to be fair, they've come out second half, and I think they have as well, with an intent to, you know, get the tempo up a little bit, which it was. And I thought we were better side comfortably second half. You know, I think we had the better player, the better chances. But, you know, they did work hard and try hard, and it turned out to be an half-decent game in the end there.
A great little poacher's goal from Andy Harvey today.
Yeah, Andy was unlucky with a couple in the first half as well. And like I said, things just didn't drop for us in the right sort of way. And, you know, the game was flat in the first half, and I thought we had the better of it. And, you know, we get a goal and, you know, we don't look back from there. But in the end, what we've had to do is we've had to dig in second half and hold on and hang on in the end there as well. So the lads have done really well.
And so far this season, 2 FA Cup games, 2 wins. Hopefully change that, put that type of performance into the league games now.
Yeah, well, to be honest, except for the Winsford game, you know, I don't think we've been a million miles away at all. We've had some tough games, a tough start. You know, you'd have liked to pick up a few more points from them games, and, you know, I think we've deserved to pick up a few more points. But like I say, football is, you know, sometimes it doesn't drop right for you, and, you know, the luck goes against you a little bit. And when you're losing, it seems to go that way a little bit more. But like I've said before, you know, you have to make your own luck in football, and I'm sure we've got the lads here that can... you know, carry on the season and put things right. And, you know, at the end of the day, you know, they do give you 100%. And sometimes, you know, games can be flat and, you know, you can't start right games, and that's what we need to put right. But none of the players we have go out intentionally to, you know, not try. I think every one of them does that. And that's what we need to improve on as a team, which is to obviously start games better, which I thought we did start the game right, and then the game went flat today. And I don't think we're a million miles away, and I think the way the league is this season being open, you know, we can push on and be right up there again once everything settles down, which I think it obviously will do in the next few weeks.
Congratulations today, though.
Yeah, it's a good win, and it's good for the club. The club work hard off behind the scenes. I mean, only as a manager do you realise how much work the club actually puts in, you know. I won't name names, but they obviously know who they are, kind of thing. And as a player, you don't see that side of it. And, you know, it's good for them to get something out of the cup today. And obviously the players have event that, and you know, I think we'll, like I say, we're pushing in the league and hopefully not look back.
Congratulations.
Cheers, Danny. Thank you.